Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Shemmassian and I've been helping students get into med school for over 15 years. Today we're going to discuss how to get into medical school with a low GPA. Getting into med school is difficult, no matter how stellar your stats are. But if you have a low GPA, you might feel like it's nearly impossible. You might wonder, with all the 4.0 students I'm competing against, what medical school would admit me? But the truth is, getting into medical school with a low GPA is not easy, but it is possible. In this video, I'll outline the best strategies to maximize your medical school admissions odds if you have a low GPA. Your GPA signals your ability to withstand the academic rigor of medical school. Generally speaking, you need a high GPA to get into medical school. The average matriculant total GPA for all US medical schools during the 2018 to 2019 cycle was 3.72. However, each individual school has its own average matriculant GPA, which may be significantly higher or lower than the national average. For example, Harvard's average matriculant GPA during the most recent application cycle was 3.9, whereas Tulane's was a 3.52. Therefore, it's important to do your research and apply to schools that are within reach based on your stats. You can click above to view the average GPA and MCAT score for every medical school in the US. So what's a low GPA? A low GPA is 0.3 or more below your target school's average matriculant GPA. All right, without further ado, let's start with the first strategy to help you get into medical school with a low GPA. Your GPA and MCAT are the two most important parts of your medical school application. If you have a low GPA, acing a few courses during senior year might not move the needle much. However, your MCAT offers some opportunity for redemption. Many students ask me, what score do I need on the MCAT? And the answer is, you should aim for your highest possible MCAT score. Why aim lower? For the entering class of 2019, the average MCAT score of matriculants was 511.2. And as you prepare, be sure to devote time to studying test strategy in addition to test content. The MCAT has a predictable question pattern, and oftentimes a lower score doesn't reflect your level of scientific knowledge, but rather inadequate preparation with respect to study strategy. The purpose of the MCAT is to test the skills and knowledge that medical schools believe is required to succeed in medical school. By maximizing your score, you can, to some degree, prove to admissions committees that you have a high level understanding of foundational concepts upon which your medical school courses will be based. Special master's programs, or SMPs, and post-bacc programs are 1 to 2 year programs specifically designed for pre-meds who have completed an undergraduate degree and are looking to boost their odds of admission into medical school. The main difference between SMPs and post-bacc programs is the types of courses you'll take. Post-bacc programs typically offer undergraduate level coursework, which gives you an opportunity to retake the classes that you struggled with during college. For many students, it's Gen Chem, O-Chem, Bio-Chem, Physics, and Biology. On the other hand, SMPs lead to a graduate level degree. This means you'll be taking courses alongside medical students, such as biochemistry, genetics, and pharmacology. This is a great option if you don't have glaring issues with specific courses, or if you have too many credits and won't benefit much from acing a single additional undergrad course. Successful completion of an SMP provides admissions committees with hard evidence that, despite your low undergrad GPA, you are capable of handling the rigors of a medical school curriculum. There are two additional benefits of completing a post-bacc or SMP program. You can develop good relationships with your professors and obtain letters of recommendation that speak to the most recent demonstration of your academic ability. The second benefit, some SMPs and post-bacc programs have linkages with medical schools, meaning there is an agreement in place which allows qualified students to matriculate into the partnering medical school. To be eligible, students typically need to meet certain GPA and MCAT requirements. If you experience the hardship that can reasonably explain an uncharacteristic drop in your grades, you can mention this in your application. Some examples of a hardship that are worth mentioning are an illness, financial hardship, or death of a family member. But be careful, this strategy is not a get out of jail free card. You should only mention a lower GPA if you have a legitimate excuse for a temporary decline in performance that significantly impacted your GPA. Some examples of scenarios in which you shouldn't use this approach: if you had a difficult transition to college, you had a difficult professor or two, and consistently earning low grades over the course of your college career. US MD programs are the most widely recognized medical education programs and therefore remain the preferred destination for the majority of medical school applicants. However, if your GPA is simply not high enough, you may still be competitive for DO programs or MD programs in the Caribbean. Many students are wary of applying to such programs because of hang-ups about prestige. However, if you're determined to become a doctor, but your numbers fall short of USMD program expectations, I recommend considering these options. In reality, students who do well in these programs and ace their board exams can go on to have successful careers in medicine just like their USMD counterparts. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. Finally, if you'd like to learn more about medical school admissions and how to increase your odds of getting in, you can also click the link in the description to get a free copy of my book, How to Get Into Medical School, which contains all the strategies we use to help students get into great medical schools, regardless of their GPA. Again, thanks so much for watching. See you next time.